Someone that I was only aware of very tangentially, you know, listening to the Gorillaz albums, Humans, that we reviewed last year. Check that out on our YouTube page. Was Little Sims. You know, she was featured on Garage Palace. Overall, I think we both felt like that project was pretty forgettable and not one that I think we've gone back to very often. But you shot me a text this week and I was like, check this out. It's pretty good. I gave it a listen. This Little Sims album, Gray Area, really blew me away. And not to step over the rest of the review, but I think this might be in the running, early running for best rap album of 2019 so far. It's only 10 tracks, 35 minutes, but it's a diverse sounding album from, you know, obviously Lil Sims, a British rapper, been around since 2010, dropping EPs and singles and mixtapes. Only has, I think, 3 feature full length albums.
Yep.
So being it's her third. And I think that this might be the one where she can finally break through and capture some more critical acclaim and attention. She's only 25, which is crazy. But before we get too far into it, Gray Area, your thoughts?
Yeah, I agree. I've listened to most of her past work, which, again, I was not aware of her until Garage Palace, that Gorillaz song specifically. Gorillaz, I saw them at the Meadows 2017. They brought Little Sims out to perform her feature on that song. And I was not even aware of that bonus track until I saw it live. And I was like, wait, this is awesome. She was great performing it. What is this song? And I went from there and slowly pieced through her all of her past work. And I think this is clearly her best project thus far. And like you said, she's only 25. But if you look at her Genius page or Wikipedia, it's quite a prolific run of music, mainly independently distributed, or I think now she's signed to Age 101. It's a indie British distribution label, so she's got very small people helping her. She's certainly not a major artist, and yeah, I agree with what you said. I hope that this gets her more mainstream attention, perhaps opens up more doors for her to, you know, access other artists, perhaps on bigger labels. But even if that doesn't come to fruition, I don't think she needs the help. She's definitely a clearly unique artist that has a lot to say, to be simple about it.
Yeah, she has a lot to say, and she takes a pretty straightforward, honest approach with a lot of it. And I think she does a pretty good job of exploring her own vulnerabilities on this, you know, like tracks like Therapy. You know, the last track that was looking at like the price of fame, and if you become famous, you know, like how it can lead to, you know, all these famous artists who have died early and all the problems that they had, things like that. So it seems like she's pretty introspective. But I think the track that probably stood out most to me was actually the first one, Offense. And that's for two reasons. One, she has this really like almost like growl, like cool delivery in it. That's like, you're just like, wow, she sounds incredible on this. But it starts off with this like crazy bass and drum, then starts layering in these flutes and other instruments afterwards. And I feel like it captures the essence of this album so perfectly. Cause there on this album, I feel like there's tracks that are a little bit more airy, a little bit lighter, more R&B-ish. That she's still rapping masterfully over, but then she has those really hard sounding tracks that really just make you want to bop. And I think that she can go back and forth between it so easily. It's just really impressive. So Offense is one that stood out to me, but talk about some tracks that maybe you liked.
Yeah, I really liked 101 FM towards the middle, just because it loosely has a FM radio theme similar to Vince Staples' last project. But like the clearly Asian influenced instrumentals and production was really cool. And then she just really rides that beat with a flow that's kind of different than what she's been showcasing the rest of the project. A lot of funny like video game references and stuff on it. But I really like that just because I thought it sounded great. Even the song right after that, Pressure, Little Dragon. And Little Dragon hasn't been wowing anyone recently, but I thought their feature was quite strong. But yeah, I think throughout this, and I mean, this was present on her past work. I think especially her last two albums really kind of showed that she was like a really important artist to watch, but even more so on Gray Area. She just has really evident technical ability that is matched with varied flows and a sound that doesn't like put you to sleep. She's a lyrical rapper that is still engaging to listen to and doesn't drone on or, you know, kind of blend in with the rest of her songs. But I think it's quite hard, quite challenging. Not every artist who raps good, you know, makes good songs. Mm-hmm. So I think, you know, this is something that, again, like I said before, I hope can really be a big springboard for her. But even if it's not, I let's do it again, to be honest, because like you said, there's a lot of lyrics here that, you know, I think there's some dense concepts. You know, you gotta really listen. You know, feminist themes, empowerment, there's a lot on here.
Yeah, you know, not that we need to be comparing, you know, the whole Nicki Minaj, Cardi B thing, but she reminded me a lot of No Name, just in terms of like the way that she's able to, I think, get a lot out there without it becoming too dense and hard to access. Obviously, I think sound wise they vary, but there, you know, there were some times like Selfish, I think, is a track that I could have definitely heard No Name actually rapping over instead of Lil Sims. But regardless, I think that Lil Sims has a great future ahead of her. You know, we haven't added one of her songs to the playlist yet. Now check that out, Nostalgia Best of 2019. I feel like we could have added almost any of the 10, so this one might be a hard choice, but I think I'm leaning towards the first one. Also, shout out Inflow, who produced this. I think he did a really great job of diversifying the sound and really texturing the tracks a lot. So